Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial video. Today I'm going to show you how to cancel your Shopify subscription and close your Shopify store. So the first thing you want to do is go to shopify.com and log in to the back end of your Shopify account and store. Once you do so, you should be able to see right here where you can click on your store to go into the back end right here where you see your dashboard. But before we do that, I want you to click on the drop down menu here next to the Shopify logo, and I want you to go to Manage Account. Once we're here, we will be in the Manage Account area under the General Settings. There's a couple of things you need to do for security reasons as well as other purposes. So, first, you want to scroll down, and first things first, make sure if you have any connected login services externally, you need to disconnect these for security purposes. Then you want to go over to the left-hand sidebar and go to the Security tab, which is right there under General. And then once you're here, you want to scroll down to where you see two-step authentication. You just want to make sure this is turned off. So if you have a method of two-factor authentication like we do here with a mobile device, you would want to remove that first and then go ahead and turn that off. And then lastly, you would need to scroll down to where you see devices and where it says logged in. You would then want to click the blue link at the very top that says log out of all devices. Again, this is just covering your bases and making sure you are protected. Once you've done those three or four things, you then can log in, click into your store here, and get to your back end or your dashboard that you're used to seeing here within Shopify. And then once you're here, I want you to click on the settings option here. It should be somewhere in the lower portion of your screen with the gear icon. If you can't find it, the easiest way of getting there is going to your search bar up here and then just typing in plan details like this. It'll then bring up a couple of options. The first one should say Shopify admin plan details. You can get there that way as well. So once here under settings, I want you to go over to where you see plan right here where it says plan. This should tell you what your Shopify plan is. So right here you can see our Shopify plan is the $79 per month option. And then once here, you're going to see your billing cycle as well as any payment methods that you use to pay for your Shopify subscription. And the first thing that you're going to want to do here is click on the red button that says deactivate store. If we click on the red button that says deactivate store, it's going to ask you and say, are you sure you want to do this? Do you just want to pause it for a bit? But what we want to do is deactivate store right here. It also lets you know that your store's information and details will be retained for 2 years. If we click on deactivate store, it'll make you go through a little bit of a form. You hit continue here once you fill the information out, and then you type in your password and you click on deactivate store. Now, once this is done, there is a couple of things that I'd like for you to do. I'm not going to deactivate the store, obviously, but what you need to do once you've deactivated your store is go to where you see your payment method, go to change payment method, and there will be an option now for you to actually remove this payment method. So you'll click on the option here, and instead of replace, it should say remove or delete or whatever it may be, and you'll want to remove that payment method just in case. But once you've deactivated your store, via the method I just showed you, you will not be billed depending on when your next billing cycle is. Obviously, you may have to contact Shopify if it's very close to your next billing date. But other than that, you just deactivate the store. Just remember, when you do this, it is permanent. They do retain your information and you can reactivate at a later time once you keep your login information. But it is indeed deactivated and your store will go offline. And that is it. That is how you deactivate and close your Shopify account as well as your Shopify store. If you have any further questions or any problems that you encounter, please put those in the comment section down below. If this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.